I understand.
The language in Commedia dell'arte. Let's take a look.
I as always like the today because when I'm at the hospital in Chinatown, I've never been to court about it's getting a bit raw. Because you want to be going to your riding when one of us are raw. Alright, I'm fine, she's gonna get it right, it's gonna raw, yeah. Yeah, what? Oh, this is gonna be a good one, Grommelot is emotional babble speak. It makes absolutely no sense at all in language, but it sounds like language. And extraordinarily enough, people understand it. As a tool, it's a fantastic improvisation game to free the brain because you do not have to use logic, you do not have to make sense, and you do not have to think or judge. You listen. It's the rhythm, it's the sound, it's like opera, it's on the breath, and it's really, really clear to the other actors.
What syllable?
I don't understand.
Using Grommelot meant that actors with different dialects could understand each other on stage, and of course the audience would understand the sense of the words.
Braun Dausteig, Rimbos.
Marika the Murfaka.
Down, down, down. I want to Rampas.
Rampas, Rampas.
It also meant that when companies toured to France and Spain and further afield, that the people watching the shows had an idea of what they were talking about if they didn't understand the actual words. But the thing that really, really irked the church was that because they weren't using real words and they were disseminators of ideas of the Renaissance, the church looked upon Commedia troops as outlaws and people who spoke with the devil's tongue.
Wonderful.
Yeah, I just love the fact that you don't understand, but you know, it just sounds like different languages, and it's such a simple way to access the listening side of the brain and the music side of the brain, because although they were improvising, they were going, you get to the end of your breath, you have to have a new breath, in comes another idea. Or, you know, I think the first time I saw Commedia in Italy, it was in Italian. I had no idea what they were talking about, but because of the breath and because of the richness of emotions, I could understand. So it becomes this kind of bridge between, across languages, you know, theatre sans frontières. It really gives people power to connect even without and before language. It's very pre-language. And I remember watching Dario Fo doing two things. One was talking about the Venetian gondoliers and the songs and the movement and the way that brings a kind of, a modus vivendi and a way of living and a way of breathing and a way of talking. And then watching him do something similar, but with the English plumber. So he didn't speak English, but he became a plumber. And it's all about attitude and approach. And in fact, Cristina mentioned a little bit of this use of the body and use of the voice when we were working with our students. Grommelot for students is so important because that's what we've just seen. It's kind of reconnects with the back brain of really listening and being.
Mario. Mario è qui questa sera ed è lui che reciterà un pezzo su un miracolo, il miracolo di Gesù Bambino, il primo miracolo di Gesù Bambino, in dialetto lombardo, ma lui l'ha recitato già in inglese, con un successo incredibile a Londra, è stato addirittura in America, è stato in tutti i paesi dove si parla inglese, perfino in Cina, nella parte della Cina meridionale. Per la prima volta, mi ricordo, a Firenze l'ho visto recitare ed era bravissimo, veramente con dei tempi, la grande, cioè era nato attore e non lo sapeva. Ora questa sera vi reciterà e vi prego di notare l'attenzione che dà alle cose che dice. Mario Pirovano. Vieni. Mario, sali.
Ecco, sono qua. No, io uso questo.
Ah, benissimo, bravo. Mario Pirovano.
Grazie.
Fammi onore.
Speriamo.
Quando in quel cielo, impienite de stelle, è arrivata dentro una gran stella, con una gran coazza, la comincia a dar delle sgiafate a tutte. Oh, le stelle, ma cos'è? Era la stella cometa, che l'arrivava dall'Oriente, l'andava a segnarghe de sotto via la strada, ai trire magi che andavano cavalcando e camelando fin giù là a Betlemme, dove era nascito il bambino Jesus, e de sotto via che era davvero trire magi. Oh, che bel, andare a col camel, la Madonna che la dina, San Giuseppe con sei castelli, giù lì che vula, il bambino della capanna che uffrigna, che bel, andare a Betlemme col camel, la Madonna che la dina, San Giuseppe con sei castelli, giù lì che vula, il bambino della capanna che uffrigna e fiagna, oh che bel, andare a Betlemme, il camel non è come il cavallo, e il cavallo va al galoppo, il camel va al trotto, gamba davanti, gamba di Dio, si inturpega, più di sotto, sono schiacciato, non arrivo più a Betlemme col camel, la Madonna che la nina, San Giuseppe, giù lì che vula, oh che bel, basta!
Yeah. You were talking that after Arlecchino in 1985, you worked a lot with them, Fo and Rame. What was the life with them? Because you mentioned that you
lived with them in their house.
Yeah,
that's right, yes. That's why I had the opportunity to, as I drank from the source, basically, you know? I drank from the fountain, from the source of the water. Daddy was painting all the time, was writing and painting at the same time, painting and writing. When the word didn't come up to his brain, he would paint. When the paint wouldn't come up, he would write down note, till the paint will come into you and it will make hundreds of drawings.
I would like to ask you, Mario, What is your experience with Commedia dell'arte, coming, of course, from Dario himself?
Well, it's a very going back to the source, really, Chiara, Emanuele. Mm-hmm. As you can see, that the costume that Dario is wearing is made out of leaf falling down, because this what was Arlecchino in the beginning. No, Arlecchino was the Homo Selvaticus. Mm-hmm. Was the one that was coming out from the wood, you know, a man was associated with also hell, incorporated in one of the most ancient masks of theater, but not only of theater, even before theater, perhaps, you know. We still do not know where Arlecchino is coming from. We know that he was born in Paris, thanks to Commedia dell'arte people who have to flee from Venice, mm-hmm. and from other town in Italy because of Counter-Reformation, mm-hmm. you know. So many companies of comediantes. They have to leave Italy because there was a kind of a religious oppression on them. Right. You know, they were not allowed anymore to perform in public places, into streets, public squares, and into theater. But also there is another reason, because they were the first to have women on stage.
Uh-huh.
That was given to me by Donato Sartori
Bella.
And his wife, Paola Pizzi.
This is
the Arlecchino, the mask of the cat, the Arlecchino mm-hmm. cat. Okay? And this is, the other one is the an old Arlecchino or an old Zanni, if you like.
Zanni, yeah.
Maybe it's like, well, this was just happened a month ago, really, in Portugal, during this festival, the Almada Festival. 37 year that they do this festival in Almada, near Lisbon, very close, opposite to the town of Lisbon, on the other side of the river of Lisbon. This big festival, so they translated the play, you know, under my supervision, and into Portuguese. And so we had 5 nights. The last night, the computer didn't work. We waited half an hour before to start, till the technician trying to repair the computer, but no way, didn't want to go. So I have to go on stage without the subtitle behind me, above my head, right? So I felt free. I didn't have to stick to the audience, to the lines anymore, you know. So I just dug in onto the stage like a crazy one, you know. And it came out really, I could tell that the audience didn't get all the story. So I was putting dialects from Venice, from Lombardy, from Spanish language, Portuguese that I could remember. And even I added up even some English words. And I remember one specific line, I couldn't get the laughter and I was desperate. And so I said it in English and they laughed.
So, I mean, this was a Gramlo, as Dario teaches, right?
What happened? I felt free. I felt free. I have noticed, I didn't have to be careful to stick to the lines. So I just went like a river flow, you know, of a situation. That was, and many people said that it was the most beautiful show ever I did in those 5 nights.
Dario Fo, durante la celebrazione in Svezia del suo premio Nobel, ringraziò Ruzzante.
Ruzzante was very important for Dario Fo. No? Mm-hmm. Ruzzante is one of the first person really that probably did professionally the Commedia dell'arte, you know. He invented the company, for example. So Dario always said that I wouldn't have written Mistero Buffo without the great lesson of Angelo Beolco, mm-hmm. Nick Ruzzante, you know. And so that's why in that specific occasion in Stockholm, during the awarding of the Nobel Prize, when it was his time to come down from the staircase, all boarded up with the medallion around his neck, and he has to do the famous discourse to the other Nobel, and in front of all the academy with the king and the queen and the prince and princess and duke or whatever, you know, we were all there just waiting for him to come down. And at the end of this prelude, he said, "That's it, that's right, my caro mio bel Ruzzante, questo pezzo di medaglione è anche per te, Ruzzante." And the English and the Swedish translation of Dario's plays and so on and everything else translated perfectly, that the audience collapsed in laughing because Dario used a kind of a slang of Ruzzante language, you know. Ciao, sto bel medaglion, sto tocco di medaglion, Ruzzante, bebe, alle anche partì.
musica molto allegre come la musica brasiliana, per questo abbiamo scelto gli spettacoli di commedia dell'arte. Noi prendiamo a volte, noi facciamo la musica, creiamo la musica, prendiamo qualche musica rinascimentale, poi di Adriano Banchieri, insomma, cioè un aspetto più storico della sonoplastia dello spettacolo, però anche la musica popolare italiana, che è straordinaria. This is a pantalone. This pantalone here is from that video that we just saw from Commedia dell'Arte.
Yeah. It's an
extraordinary actor that does, it's Santiago, his name.
No, the pantalone is fantastic. The pantalone and the balanzone, very, very good.
Sì, molto bello.
Vecchietto. Poi anche questo magnifico più vecchio tra le mie.
Bello.
Poi c'è ecco, naturalmente l'Arlecchino.
Bellissimo questo.
Una versione di un Pulcinella, questo fatto per un attore di Spagna. Ecco. Attore?
Sì.
Eccolo, che carino questo dottore.
Poi Brighella anche, ecco, ci sono tante. Ecco. Ci sono. E poi c'è anche un Zanni. A verga, più grasso, più grande, rosa la gola.
Stupendo.
E poi c'è anche il capitano, questo capitano fatto, vero? Si è appropriato di una forma straordinaria, Marco, che si è specializzato nella maschera.
Io sono il gran capitano, ma tanto.
Haim Scapino Abud and Orit Peres.
E uno e due.
And welcome to La Commedia in Quarantena, Orit and Haim.
Shalom.
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 Shalom from Israel. You don't see the limits when you have the mask on your face. Mm. And part of the limits come out because they think they are limited. Mm. And once they put the mask and they see pantalon or arlecchino, and it's pantalon or arlecchino, nobody knows that you are have these problems, they are flying, you know?
Yeah, I love it. The kids' energy is, yes, yes. Everything is, yes, let's do it. Yes, I love it. What, everything is yes. So that's why it's amazing to work with kids, yeah.
This is our first work. I mean, actually, we did a lot of Commedia dell'Arte in the last 20 years. A few years ago, we saw a full mask show made by Familia Flues. They are Germans.
Right. Oh, yeah, Emanuele knows them well.
I love seen
them, Emanuele. Yeah, Family Flues.
And we decided as part of our research about mask work in theater to do this kind of a show. We went to Italy, actually. We had a workshop of 2 weeks with them. It was kind of in the lab facilities from 9 to 9, working with our body.
The important thing is that the show take place in a plastic surgery clinic.
It's about 40% improvised. I mean, we just opened the newspaper or let's say the web, see about the situation in the country or abroad, and you can see it on stage a few minutes afterwards. And people really like it. People saw it about more than 10 times. It's kind of, and we've been everywhere with this. The Commedia dell'Arte, actually, yeah, we're talking about Pulcinella and Napoli and Bergamo. It works on archetypes, you know, an archetype of the people, of the whole societies, you know. So if they see Pantalone over there on the stage or Pulcinella, maybe they don't know the roots that come from Napoli, but they know the roots from their archetype that they know from those who surround them, okay? So once they are open to this culture, and then they can see like the archetypes that are talking the same language they know. We are not talking Italian. So this is connected the audience to our work, you know, to the Commedia dell'Arte.
It's a truth, and I'm only